Here's the spot for all of our music. You know, this we do all this music. Well, the Bellrays is gonna be it. You know, but the Bellrays sort of became its own thing, and some of the music that we were trying to do in the Bellrays, it didn't have a home there. It needed somewhere else. So that's Leasing the Lips is an extension of that. The music that was always there, but otherwise a Bellrays show would be 5 hours long and.
Yeah.
You know, there'd be 642 songs every night.
That question comes up a lot, though. So yeah. I'd really like to address that.
Yeah.
Because I think it's so weird that a musician is relegated to being in one thing.
Exactly, yeah.
That anybody would ever think about that. But you have managers, you have all of these other things that work inside the business, and they work with all different artists.
But it's weird for a musician to do that.
But it's so weird, because a creative person couldn't be that creative and be doing more than one
project. Different.
You know, you have to really understand where music has come from to see how focus and how it has to be down to this little narrow pinpoint of a position. When the Beatles were doing records, it was okay for things to just be expansive and everything else. If a band like that tried to get signed today, people would laugh at them. They would say that there's no way that you could do all these things or whatever. And basically that's the thing that we've been dealing with any types of music that we've been doing.
Industry and it has tend to, and an extension of that is journalism and stuff. They really sell audiences short. They tell them, well, you can't possibly listen to all of this. You only have to listen to this. You know, your subgroup type A1, 0.56.
Yeah.
You have to listen to these five selections of music. Selling the population short, people will glom onto stuff. People who are, completely diehard rock and roll Bellrays fans, they come up and they had no idea that we could do something like Leasing the Lips.
And they love it.
And they love it.
The Lips fans love the Bellrays.
Yeah, and these guys, these people are like tatted up.
Leather.
They're looking like that, and they come up and I really like that Troubled Mind song. And it's
of course you do.
Yeah,
because it's like music.
It's like, that's not surprising.
At some point, people stopped trying to actually do music and they started trying to sell records.
Yeah.
And that's a very different point of view. It's not looking at the fact that everything isn't supposed to be for everybody.
We'll be right back.
because everybody else is listening to Rihanna or whatever it is that somebody's dropped $15 million into for you to see, it doesn't mean that that's what I'm supposed to attach myself to. Otherwise, it wouldn't have to keep dropping $15 million into it for people to like it. So there's my tirade for that question.
That was a short version.
Art is not a place where you go and you try to make a lot of money out of it.
Yeah.
You try to just spread it out there. And I know that, you know, people in the past have been lied to, they've been told that this is art, this is good, when somebody was pulling a bunch of bullshit behind them and saying, buy it. Now that you have things that are really trying to float to the top without the help of anybody, you know, backing them on a label or doing these other things, or clubs that are really just trying to put on shows and you have somebody putting their thumb down on them, it doesn't make any sense because that's the direct access to the people.
You need this infusion of art, you need this infusion of creativity to keep things going. When that creativity and that level of artisanship dies, then
I mean, in a world of trouble.
You might as well just suck on a gun because there's nothing worth living for, because after that it's drudgery and money.
Because let me tell you, people, anything that you see on the radio or you see on MTV or any of that other stuff is not a reflection of what you actually want. I am encouraged by the number of people that come up when we do these shows. At the end of the show, and they just say, oh my God, I had such a great time listening to this music.
I'm happy. I'm feeling something, you know.
I love that. I mean, when was the last time that most of these people have heard music that actually touched them in that way? I had a 60, maybe 70-year-old woman come up to me after that show, that last one that we did. And she grabbed me and she spoke to me in Spanish and...
But you got the message.
I got the message that she got what she needed and she didn't even know it was still out there.
She had given up
on what music could be. That's awesome. And they are missing something that is essential.
Thing over here where, you know, artisanship and stuff is a big deal here. I mean, it really is, and I know people who live here think, well, God, you know, the government is hanging out. I can go to the States and see what an artist has to go through in the States. What they used to be, now you're just a game I don't play. In the United States, they think art is this thing where you're just, you know, dancing through the park, you know, farting out stuff that nobody cares about.
And yet,
art is everything they sell. You know, every TV commercial, every music video, every song, everything, it's all art. It's all created by somebody. Art drives everything. If you can't build a building without somebody, without an artist designing it, you can't do anything without an artist designing it first. And try to get that message, you know, into America, and, you know, they look at you like you have lobsters crawling out of your ears or something. They have no idea what you're talking about. Mm-hmm. And yet, you know. I'm tired of living in disguise. I'm not trying to pretend to be deathly blind. I won't give you one more day. Is different. Europe, even Germany and Switzerland and places that you don't think normally, you know, I mean, it's just one of those things.
Love you guys.
Yeah, you know.
Expectations. World domination.
Yeah.
continuación, nuestra agenda de conciertos. Lunes 10 de noviembre, concierto recomendado por Rockpills, Feedback Revival en el Gran Café. Día 27, concierto recomendado por Rockpills, Sex Museum en el Gran Café. Viernes 13 de diciembre, Festival Country Charro en Salamanca, con Death Bronco, Urban Pioneers, The Freebon Brothers, In Blau, Redneck Surfers, Carballo y Bye Bye Lullaby. Lunes 1 de diciembre, concierto recomendado por Rockpills en el Gran Café León, Wild Adriatic. Shine for All the People es el nuevo disco de Mike Farris y el disco del mes en Rockpills.